अस्सलाम वालेकुम एंड वेलकम बैक टू द अलिफ पॉडकास्ट। आज मेरे साथ हैं ताहा जी। हाउ आर यू सर?
आई एम गुड, हाउ आर यू डूइंग?
गुड, बीन अ व्हाइल, वी हैव बीन ट्राइंग टू लाइन दिस अप। वी हैव बीन अ बिजी मैन।
मैन, आई एम सॉरी मैन,
यू नो,
आई एम हियर नाउ।
टोटली कूल। लास्ट वीक यू हैड योर बिग लॉन्च विद योर लाइव बैंड।
यस यस, विद माय लाइव बैंड ताहा एंड द जीज।
यस,
एंड इट वाज अमेजिंग। इट वाज अमेजिंग एंड it's an exciting step towards the in the future, you know, like,
yeah,
let's see what's gonna happen.
It's gonna be cool. I mean, I'm excited,
taking a leap of faith, and let's see, you know, the team's good.
Yeah,
so I'm excited.
I think it's important. I mean, we'll get to it because we'll start with some, you know, your early stuff, but let's save that for a bit later. So how about we start with what is your earliest memories of, you know, being into music or dancing or just wanting to sing?
Earliest memory, I was in school, ninth grade. I was in Bayview, and this channel, I forgot the name, ATV? I think it was ATV back then. They came to our school and they kept a competition for singing, and I took part in it. I got selected. We had auditions.
Yeah.
And I sang Pehli Nazar. Uh-huh. And I won that competition. Oh, wow. That's my earliest memory of singing. But then watching that back on TV was really embarrassing because everyone was watching it at home.
Yeah.
And thoda ajeeb laga.
Yeah.
But yeah, that was the earliest. But and I always loved dancing.
And how old were you then?
I was 9th grade, 13.
Huh,
13, huh. 13 years old.
Yeah. And you already, like, were you, I know you're a big Michael Jackson fan. And stuff, so you're already into that?
I was already into that. I remember my dad got this DVD. This Is It, that was his documentary for the last show he was going to do, the last tour he was going to do. It was called This Is It.
Yes.
And I used to watch that all the time. I used to look at him the way he used to dance and perform. And you know how everything was so choreographed, just to give you like a performance, make you feel something, you know, not just being there. It was his presence so strong on the stage. And I admired, and I've always wanted to be like that. Bachpan se, you know, ki yaar is tarah nachna hai.
I had tickets to see him on the This Is It tour, and literally he passed away. I had the ticket.
It was so sad. I remember back then we used to have MSN, and that's where all the news would come online. And I remember opening it, and I just saw that when I woke up one day. It was pretty sad.
Yeah, and then they had this if you had the ticket, you could either keep it as a souvenir or you could get the refund. And stupidly, I just got the refund. But I think if I still had the ticket, it'd be worth 20 times more today.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Much more.
So, uske baad, like in your later teens, did you experiment like making your own songs at that point, or did that come later?
Well, that was a much later stage in life.
Mm-hmm.
I was wanted to be an economist. I wanted to be the youngest economist in Pakistan.
Oh, wow.
I remember I got into a foundation program at 15 for econ.
Where?
In Malaysia.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I got good grades in O-levels. I don't know how.
Yeah.
And then I got a scholarship. So I went there.
Yeah.
I was in uni at the age of 16.
Oh, wow.
And then I also got an offer from City University, London. But couldn't afford to go there back then. And yeah, I was on track, and then I was like, I'll go do a master's right after my bachelor's. I'm going to be the youngest economist in Pakistan.
Yeah.
But then, that's the funny story. I met my two flatmates, Sebastian and Steve, who were doing audio engineering at SAE in London. And they were my flatmates, and I started, you know, picking up their instruments, playing the guitar a little bit, starting to learn from them. Started off with a C major scale, easiest scale, you know, to learn on the guitar.
Yeah.
That's where I started off. And I used to do covers initially, and he used to play the guitar, Sebastian, my flatmate. And I used to be really bad. I'm not gonna lie, I was trash.
So what kind of songs were you covering?
Maroon 5, Wonderwall, typical, you know,
typical
songs. But then one day, you know, like, I don't know, I'm not gonna mention what made me start writing a song, but I started writing a song. And from then onwards, I just loved the fact that I could use this instrument and say my thoughts, sing my thoughts on top of it, and it can make someone feel something and know that they're not alone in those thoughts, like in those emotions.
Right.
And I was like, yeh karna hai. And then I had to drop out of uni because of financial issues. I was in second year uni in London by now.
Mm-hmm.
But then I had to drop out because of financial issues, and I didn't finish my university. And then I was like, you know, emotional support. बाथरूम में बैठ के गाने 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 बनाने कुछ नहीं करना. अम्मी अबू बोल रहे हैं जाओ वापस पढ़ाई शुरू करो यहीं शुरू करो नहीं जॉब करो. देन आई डिड सम जॉब्स एज वेल ऑड जॉब्स ऑन एंड ऑफ वर्क्ड एट आईबैक्स वर्क्ड एट सीडर एंड बस. लेकिन दिस आई नेवर लेफ्ट एंड आई स्टार्ट गेटिंग बेटर बेटर बेटर. बस लिखता है गाने आई डेंट केयर कि कितने बेकार हैं. क्योंकि इनिशियल मेरी पहली एल्बम एक तो पहले पूरी सी मेजर के स्केल पे है एंड बस वो बेकार गाने थे. लाइक आई डोंट साउंड ओके मे बी देयर ओके देयर ओके
बट इट्स लाइक अ सॉन्ग राइटिंग इज लाइक अ मसल दैट द मोर यू वर्क इट आउट द बेटर यू गेट.
दैट्स एनीथिंग जितना आप टाइम दोगे किसी चीज को आप उतना बेहतर होगे उस पे.
बिल्कुल
या एंड देन बस अब यहां है गाने बना रहे हैं अभी भी.
अच्छा मजे की बात है मैं भी पहले इकोनॉमिस्ट था.
ओह डैम एंड देन यू रियलाइज कि इस दुनिया में इकॉनमी बकवास है झूठ है.
हां बिल्कुल सो फ्री मार्केट कैपिटलिज्म इज अ लाई इट्स अ स्कैम. बट खैर सो देन व्हाट वाज द फर्स्ट लाइक सिंगल दैट यू देन रिलीज्ड. At what point did you think it was good enough that I can put this out?
I actually don't know where I got the confidence to actually release that stuff. Because it was called Pyar Aata Jata Hai. And in that time, I was quite inspired by Noori. You know, the rock element. So I would be singing like full... like, you know, full deep voice.
Yeah.
But... then I remade that song again. So that song has been released like thrice, again and again and again.
So did you work with different producers every time, or did you do it yourself?
Yeah. So the first time it was with my flatmates. It was actually their project for their school, sorry, for the university.
Ah, okay.
It was an assignment, and they had to record a song. Yeah, they had to record a song, and they're like, "You have a song. Let's do it. Let's do this."
Yeah.
And we did that as an assignment for them. It was fun because we went to what's it called? Got the name of the place now, but it was amazing. The
studio, in London
only. The studio was amazing.
Yeah.
So like my first song being recorded in the top of the line studio.
Yeah.
Which has been used by Arctic Monkeys and stuff like that.
Oh wow.
So, like, for me, it was actually pretty insane being there.
Yeah.
So the start was great.
Yeah.
But then I started doing it at home once I was back here. But then slowly progressed onto different studios. So initially it was with them. Second time it was with another studio in North Nazibabad. Then the third time was with Abdullah Kasumbi once, actually, yes.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. And then...
in his early days.
Yeah, in his early days. And your everyone's early days. Early days, I believe.
And then, so you came here pretty early on. We had just started up. At Alif, and you were here with some early stuff as well. I don't know where in the timeline that fits.
That's pretty early. That's my first album. No, that actually would be my second album. Could Be Gold was the song's name. I brought it here to be mixed and mastered, I remember.
Yeah,
and that's when I visited,
And so what's your, at that point, what was your songwriting process like? Going through some experience and just writing about it?
So initially, always I started off my songs by writing it on the guitar. उसको आहिस्ता आहिस्ता फिर मैं अभी सीखना शुरू किया था FL Studio. I still work on FL Studio. काफी producers will not like that. But...
it's a tool.
I know,
it
better
yeah.
than the other ones. So, you know, other DAWs. So,
yeah.
तो उस पे फिर मैं वही chords में गिटार पे जाता था उनको कन्वर्ट करता था MIDI में एंड लाइक यू नो पुट सिंथ्स ऑन मेस अराउंड विद द स्केल्स यू नो लाइक डू वाज वेरी एक्सपेरिमेंटल इन द सेंस आई डिडंट काइंड ऑफ नो आई काइंड ऑफ न्यू व्हाट आई वाज डूइंग बट आई डिडंट एंड आई वाज जस्ट गोइंग अलोंग विद हियरिंग यू नो विद माय हियरिंग एंड आराम आराम से बस वो बस ऐसे ही फिर होता था. फिर उसके ऊपर मैं लिरिक्स लिख देता था मेलोडी बना ली.
एंड डिड यू एवर लाइक टेक एनी वोकल लेसंस और जस्ट खुद बहुत
बस जो कवर्स किए गाने लिखता गया
या
बजाता गया. I guess after a while you also realize when you're not hitting notes.
Yeah. You need some practice.
No, but Ahad Hussain helped me out a lot.
Yeah.
He's on my team. He's been my vocal producer for a while now as well.
Yeah.
He's helped me a lot. He's taught me exercises.
Mm.
He always makes sure, like, I do warm-ups before my shows as well and before my recordings as well. So I give a lot of credit to him for where I am today as well, with my vocally.
Yeah.
But there's also been a lot of other people who have helped out, you know,
mm-hmm.
writing, melody-wise as well.
Mm. So, at what point did you, like, feel like this getting somewhere? Like, isse kuch ho sakta. I mean, ab to mashallah, you have quite a following.
Thank you.
But, you know, I remember in the early days, you were just starting out and no one knew who you were, you know?
Yeah, so, like, initially, na, main apne gaane khud hi mix bhi kar raha hu, master bhi kar raha hu, produce bhi kar raha hu, record bhi kar raha hu ghar pe. I don't know all of that, man. I'm going to mess it up. Like, I'm bound to mess it up.
Yeah.
And not do it properly.
Hmm.
I remember then, ek gaana tha man mein tu mera.
Hmm.
Once again, I was just going to release it without, you know, like, getting it mixed and mastered by someone, but mixing it myself. Jo bhi YouTube se seekha hai.
Yeah.
Like, I still give myself credit ki kafi acha seekh liya tha. But, yeh hai ke I took that song to Adil because Dino had told me.
Yeah.
Dino was like, bro, ye gaana acha hai.
Yeah.
Isko master aur mix karao. And I took it to Adil after Zahid Bhai actually.
Yeah.
Got us acquainted.
That's when Adil was here?
No, that's when Adil was back home as well. Yeah. This is like the first time I'm getting a mix and mastered. And that song did well because I also invested in the music video for it. Like properly music video bhi banayi uski. And it did pop off.
Yeah.
A little bit. So I was like, oh, okay. Nice.
Yeah.
Then right afterwards, thode time baad hi Dopal bhi aa gaya. Dopal went wild as like aasmanon mein.
Yeah.
And then I was like, yo, like, ye scene hai, kafi acha hai.
Dopal was with Manu.
Manu, yes, with Manu. And then phir thode time baad Dil Ke Ishaare bhi aa gaya. Like, ever since then, it's been nice. It's been very nice.
What I really like, thing that you did really well, especially when you were starting off, is consistency in the releases. You know, just making, like, I think there was every month or so that you were releasing a track at one point.
Yeah.
And I think aajkal ki jis tarah how the algorithms function, that really caters to that. So was that a conscious decision ke I need to make sure ke I have something out every month, every other month, you know?
Like, after a while, success with Man Mein Tu wagaira, I saw that I don't have to stop now. And I had just given myself a goal that I have to do this. You know, like, because in my mind, there was complacency in everyone. Everyone comes. You know, it's very natural. We're human beings. And I was like, no, this can't happen. Like, goal is to keep this 12 months, this year, 12 months, every month, we have to make a song. And I didn't actually release more than 12 songs in that year.
Yeah.
So, you know, like, hey, definitely, you know, aajkal, there's so much music out in the world.
Yeah.
And not every song is going to cater to every listener. No. Some songs are going to be another person's cup of tea. You know? So, I love experimenting. I like trying different styles out. The only way to get these styles out is ke main karta rahun. You're only going to get better, you know?
Like, yeah,
this is how it is. But obviously now I've slowed it down a bit, like my releases.
Yeah.
Abhi bhi chal rahi thi kaafi tez, but now I'm like, I'm going to take a 2-3 month break from releases.
Yeah.
Take some time, you know, let people breathe.
So at what point did you have your first show with your own original kind of songs and stuff?
I think this was back in 2015, yeah, 16, at The Grid.
That's way back,
yeah. At The Grid.
And like, there you performed your original material?
Me and Ahad
performed. Oh, yeah.
I even have a poster I should have kept uski picture mein dikhata. I'll send it to you, maybe you can add that.
That would be cool.
Like, you can add that.
Ching, idhar. Yeah.
So Ahad and me, like, it was just an acoustic guitar and me singing. We did covers as well, but we did a lot of originals then. Because I had just released my new album, like first album, sorry. And I was like, yeah, isko market karte hain. Aur phir Grid abhi khula tha. Oh, this is a perfect spot to do it, it's close by.
And like,
it's a nice place.
Yeah. So, how was the response of that first show? What do you remember?
It was nice. A lot of people showed up, actually. It was like around 100 people.
Nice.
Yeah, and that was a small space, so 100 people, वैसे इतना ज़्यादा लग रहा था मतलब. And मज़ा आया, सबको मज़ा भी आया. यही था कि बस बहुत अदास गाने ज़्यादा गा लिए थे. That first album was sad.
Is that first album available?
On SoundCloud, yes.
No, so you didn't put that on Spotify?
No, I'm not too proud of it. Not
no, okay. It's like, but I'm if like, you want to dig deeper, you can find
it. Yeah. You can hear it on SoundCloud.
Achha. Haan, because I was doing, obviously, I know some of your catalog, but I was doing my research.
You found it? Did you find it?
I didn't come across it because I was only looking on Spotify.
Oh, no.
But मैं बाद में सुनूंगा.
नहीं ओके जस्ट मे बी मेक अ कंपैरिजन यू कैन.
या या
आई डू दैट सम टाइम्स. आई वाज लाइक वाओ ओके.
मेरा भी पुराना स्टफ साउंडक्लाउड में पड़ा है.
ओह
बट सो व्हेन डिड द परफॉर्मेंस एस्पेक्ट कम इन लाइक डांस एंड यू नो ऑल ऑफ दैट.
डांस आई थिंक केम मच लेटर. When I did this album called Gun to My Head.
Yeah.
And it was a very hip hop album. And that's when I kind of started, like, I performed it live for the first time. I don't know if you remember Salt, Super Salt, about that?
Yes.
Shamoon, Ismail, yeah. Misha Shafi performed inside.
Yeah.
But there was a stage outside as well.
Yes.
I performed on that stage.
Ah.
Yeah, I performed on that stage. And was the time I played the electronic kiya tha. And I did that hip hop album, but I was like, yeah, it's hitna zaruri hai thoda. You know, if I just stand there and do it, it's pretty, gonna be pretty boring now.
Yeah.
Because that requires a lot of energy from you so that the crowd also goes hyped up, you know, like, yeah. Oh, mazaa aa raha
hai. Yeah.
You know, like,
yeah.
And then I did, people started enjoying, I saw people were enjoying your yari energy at stage. Mm. And then slowly I obviously moved away to funk right after that. And that requires you to dance. And then obviously Michael Jackson comes back into my head.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah. Let's do it. And people started loving it. I could see the smiles abroad, the you know, people laughing.
Yeah.
You know, it's fun. Seeing you, who is crazy? What happened? But it's fun.
How much confidence is coming? How much stage pe nach.
Thankfully, that won't be happening anymore.
But like, did you, like, how did you choreograph your moves beforehand, or is it all in the moment that you
go? It's all happening in the moment. Like, but then, I started realizing a pattern. Like, there was these certain moves that I would always do at a certain part in the song. I was like, "Bas, ye part iska ban gaya ye, iska ban gaya ye." But now the plan is like, we have the band ready.
Yeah.
Now there's has to be more additions to the G's with dancers.
Now
I wanna, cause I want to make a whole showcase. I want it to be done properly. Koi baat nahi, agar saal mein mujhe char show karna pade khali in different cities, I'll do it. But I want it to be done properly. Dancers, you know, it's a performance, it's choreographed. Like, I also get a chance to breathe at certain points.
Yeah.
Maybe go change my outfit.
Yeah.
Come back, you know. Yeah. I want to take that to the next level. Pakistan mein nahi hua ye.
Haan, nahi. Bilkul.
And I want ke hamare bhi yahan concerts aise ho. Hopefully. Hopefully.
I think it's a dream. Yeah.
We can dream. Let's dream big, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, I think you've taken a big step by getting the band together. But before that, let's talk about, like, you know, so once you started getting a bit more traction and popularity, did you notice, you know, a change in how people, like, how's your family responded to you going into music? Like,
yeah, me and my mummy abu dekhenge podcast. Mujhe pata hai, this is all my podcast. Yeah, I mean, like,
matlab pehle bataya na, first they wanted you to go down the economics route.
But jis tarah hota hai, if you see it from their perspective, you do understand why.
Of course.
Because back then khatam tha music ka scene, like, yeah. Honest, you know, like, mera Canada ka visa reject ho gaya tha from SAE, saying ke Pakistan mein koi scope hi nahi hai, aap nahi kar sakte audio engineering. You know, like, so it was an actual problem back then.
Yeah.
But thankfully, Spotify is here now. You know, so many different streaming platforms are here now. People are, we have more listeners now here as well. Open to listening to Pakistani music, which is very inspired from Western music.
Yes.
You know, like, pehle nahi tha.
Spotify ke aane se, what did you notice practically? Did your audience expand?
A lot.
Yeah.
A lot. Man, because, like, jo playlists aati hai na, aapko, they really do help you a lot. They've helped me a lot. And then the Radar documentary helped me a lot.
Yeah, that was nice.
You know, they boosted me. They boosted me a lot. And like, my face was shown to a lot of people, you know. So awareness create ki thi kafi. Like,
so have you noticed, like, more fans from outside Pakistan?
Yeah, funnily enough, I think I have more fans and listeners in India.
Oh, really? Wo to aksar Pakistani artists ke saath hi hota hai.
Yeah,
man. It's a sign of success, though.
On the way. Obviously, still not that much as I would want.
Yeah.
But it's something, and I'm blessed from where I started off.
Right.
From zero to wherever I am right now, it's incredible.
And have they tried to get you to come there for performances and stuff?
I've been invited for private gigs and weddings, but obviously we can't go.
Yeah.
Hopefully one day. That'd be amazing.
Dubai mein karenge to jaakar.
Dubai mein, in any other part of the world.
Yeah.
Any other part of the world, I'll come and do it.
Hmm.
Yeah.
So have you performed outside Pakistan yet with your stuff?
Huh?
Have you performed outside Pakistan yet?
I mean, not like, what's it called? In the sense of like openly.
Right.
Yeah.
And private events.
Private. Yeah.
But you know, I mean, I think with the band situation, that can really open you up to a lot of places.
It's incredible, the potential.
You know,
it can go anywhere.
So let's talk about, so where did the idea come from that let's put a band together and change this up, you know?
It was always the goal to have a band, because nothing better than live music, nothing better than the sound of an actual snare hitting.
Yeah.
You know, the actual bass playing, the groove to it, you know, like there's a swing to, especially funk music.
Mm-hmm.
You need that swing from the live band. It's just going to add so much more.
Mm.
And ye kaafi time se tha in the works, like me and Adil have been talking about it for 2 years now.
Mm.
You know, like 2 years se ye baat chal rahi hai ki ye karna hai. We even tried it 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And it's one of my biggest PTSD moments of my life. You know, like we got on stage, they can't hear themselves. They're playing God knows where. I'm sounding trash.
Yeah.
And you know, like aage se crowd dusre artist ka naam chala raha hai, ye
no.
And being booed.
So where,
you know, like,
where was this?
This was Moin Khan Stadium.
Acha.
Yeah. So it was fun, you know. I got off stage and mentally broken, you know.
Yeah.
Or
lineup
yahi tha. I was breaking down. Huh?
Uspe lineup kya tha?
Lineup, it was Natasha Beg, Asim Azhar, Asha Wajahat. Yeah.
But in terms of your band, was it the same guys?
Oh, it was me, Adil and Ahad.
Okay.
Hum sabka yahi PTSD, hum teenon ka. We always speak about, like, we always talk about it to each other. We're like, yaar, ye nahi ho sakta. Abhi show se pehle bhi, we were like, bhool jao, woh hua kabhi.
Yeah.
But back then, we only practiced for like 4 days. 4 days jam kiya, that's not enough.
Yeah.
This time, we've put hours into it, like countless hours into it. Like around 100, bahut ka, like 50 plus hours.
Yeah.
Easily.
Yeah.
More than that, actually.
Yeah, I mean, to set it up initially,
it took time. Obviously, we had to learn, you know, like, they had to make the parts as well, what they're going to play. And bas ye goal tha, and like, I'm so fucking, you can bleep that, right?
No, it's okay. It's a mature audience.
Yeah, okay, I'm proud. I'm proud of everyone in the team. They made my dream come true. Because, like, band ke saath stage pe aane ka scene hi alag hai. The energy is different. The sound is so much better.
And how did you manage, like, the rehearsal process? Did you have, like, did you take a producer hat and say, hey, um logon ne ye mindset ke saath bajana hai? Or you let them interpret it and then you gave them feedback?
No, so we, initially me, Adil, Aha, then Amar would sit down.
Yeah.
And obviously we'd see, ki yaar, kaun se hum log na iske, jo hai humari stems gaane ki, kaun se hum use kar sakte hain, jo hum log replicate shayad na kar paen, you know, like the sounds that we can't replicate. But initially to ye tha ki we've always been that kind, ki we've always been like giving each other like
ideas and
feedback, ki ye acha nahi hai, ye theek nahi hai. So it was really collaborative effort. There are certain things that I didn't like, aur us pe to main hard no tha.
Yeah.
Arsal loves playing, rides a lot. Main usko kaafi jagahon pe mana karta tha. But I love his playing as well. He also, you know, sabne diye apne input, sabke the.
Yeah.
And like, I think that's the way it should be, you know, like the more jitne zyada dimag hai utna behtar hoga. Like, ho sakta hai, hope kharab bhi ho sakta hai, lekin if you guys gel together well and bond,
yeah,
and chemistry
is important.
Agar hai to you, and you understand the songs, and
yeah,
you know, because we didn't want to get like go away too much from the originals. We still wanted to keep that originality to it,
yeah,
but also with like a new flavor.
No, still, I mean, I saw the launch show that you did, and I was particularly impressed with how Arsal was locked down to, you know,
he was
parts.
Locked in, he was locked in.
I mean, he's a phenomenal drummer,
and no, this shows it even more, you know, like the fact that he was there in time every time.
Yeah,
he was being minimal with the drum kit in his heart, and he did it. He was amazing there.
Yeah. So what's some of your more memorable shows that you've had so far? I mean, and not including the recent one, because that's a whole different category. We've talked
that's
about
most
that.
Memorable,
yeah, that's.
There's been a couple. Actually, we were just talking about Morph.
Mm-hmm.
Morph was one. That was actually the first one. I think that was a very iconic show.
Yeah.
That started off the movement, I think, for all of us artists.
That was when?
It's been a while now, man. I don't even remember. 2020? No, it was after COVID, wasn't it? 2021.
Mm.
Actually, then उससे पहले एक show था district पे.
Yeah.
District पे वो था, it was me, Manu and Hassan.
Mm-hmm.
That show was wild. That was amazing. That was the first time I felt like, because people sung Dopal on the top of the log, and I was like, oh yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, मजा आ गया. But then it was Morph. It was very iconic. अभी recent times been Nautanki.
Mm-hmm.
Incredible, like the biggest setup I've seen in Pakistan.
Hassan Rahim's launch. Yeah.
Actually, no, the biggest setup was Flaming Hot. Oh, that was incredible.
Where was that?
That was in Lahore.
And what was the lineup then?
That was also Hassan, me, Manu, Natasha Nani.
Mm-hmm.
Two different lineups, but I did it twice. Hanan as well.
Yeah.
That was great. That was incredible. Now, if you remember, the setup was insane. Like something you'd see
mm-hmm.
outside, you know, like not in Pakistan. I've never seen a setup like that in Pakistan ever. Nautanki and Flaming Hot, both.
Like in terms of that, what, big LED screens and stuff.
Yeah. I mean, just the sound-wise as well. Like, you know, like
what
sound.
Was the venue?
For Nautanki, so I did all three.
Mm-hmm.
Karachi, mein it was Tree Club.
Mm-hmm.
Lahore, mein it was a park. I do not remember the name.
Yeah.
And in Islamabad, it was also at a park that I do not remember. Rava Lake.
Yeah.
It was at the
Rava Lake.
Okay. Yeah.
Nice.
That was pretty sick. Yeah.
Now, do you feel like sometimes, because I mean it's a little different with.
Actually, no, I wasn't at Rava Lake. I just remember somewhere else. I think it was Shakarpadiya. Yeah.
Ah, okay.
Yeah,
Ab you might feel this issue going forward, given that you have a band, but there's a definite lack of proper venues in Pakistan.
Oh, there is.
You know, so wo kabhi hota hai frustration ke yaar, you know, why isn't there certain facilities or
yeah, you know. Like for example, now it's summers, right?
Yeah.
Kahan karein perform?
Hmm.
You know, AC mein kahan karein?
Yeah.
Unless we set something up ourselves in like a warehouse or something.
Mm.
You know, there's no proper, like, maybe there was FTC, but apparently FTC doesn't give out their auditorium anymore.
Mm.
You know, so like, we don't really have indoor venues here in Pakistan.
Yeah.
So like, pure summers, for example, like May till September.
Yeah.
You don't have many shows. मोटे हो रहे हैं, समोसे खा रहे हैं, क्या खा रहे हैं, बर्गर खा रहे हैं, कुछ कर ही नहीं रहे.
Yeah.
Oh, we make the music then, to be honest, वैसे.
Yeah.
Summers is the time to make music, I guess, for us.
Prepare the
releases. And prepare the releases. But it'd be nice to perform in the summer, you know.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. That, you know, if they were more indoor, properly secured and, you know, sound adjusted sound. Akshar, like, venue bhi mil jata hai, but it's not treated.
Yeah.
And then things are just bouncing around and it's just awful.
That's the worst. You know? The slap bag is the worst thing to deal with.
We were talking also, different topic now, offline, we were talking about you getting into a little bit of acting as well.
Yes. I just actually did my first scene today.
Today?
First and only scene right now.
Gotcha. So how did that come about?
I've always liked to act. I think I've always been acting in my music videos as well.
Mm.
And I wanted to try something new out as well.
Yeah.
You know, like, why not? I tried. This year's just been about trying new things out.
Mm.
First the band, now this.
Yeah.
I would love to act, you know.
So like, is this like for like a drama serial or something?
This is
a
drama serial, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Pehli Barish, I think is the name, yes.
Mm.
The first scene of the drama.
Okay.
So I'm excited. Opening with me. Yeah, let's go.
Well, good luck with that.
देखते क्या होते हो गया acting तो कर ली आज देखते हैं
क्या कहते हैं so अभी ये break लोगे उसके बाद फिर क्या plan है
so I have releases planned
mm-hmm.
a few releases planned but the goal is to come back refreshed you know energized
yeah
get back into it sit down with the band working on an album with them hopefully mm-hmm. if they're all down
yeah.
Well, I think they are though. Yeah. They're very excited. We're all very excited to work with each other.
I mean, I don't think Pakistan's ever had a funk album, and that's Mughle
Funk.
Mughle Funk is a I mean, it is a little bit of funk, but it's a lot of like I don't know, instrumental.
You could say
classical.
Disco, maybe. I would say disco, maybe.
Yeah.
Disco funk. Yeah. Yeah.
But good call. I mean, that is a funk band
out there. Yeah. But yeah, like it's exciting, because you know, like I don't think many people are aware of funk here.
No.
You know, but at least the Pakistani audience, like I mean, the Pakistani Jonai listeners.
Exactly.
I don't think they're aware of funk that much.
I mean, the history of Pakistani popular music is mostly pop and rock. You know.
Mm, yeah. Yeah, but
and then it's classical.
Not, yeah, like but. You know, like Junaid Jamshed.
Yes.
Was also a little, like, sorry, Vital Signs, I would say. They were a little bit, you could say, funky sometimes.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's never been like a main focus. Plus, with funk, you really need like that, you know, that upbeat element, which a lot of our popular music has been more like. Melancholic and emotional. You know, I think wo ghazal history se
bhi wo hai. Sad souls hain yaar Pakistan mein udaas. Hum yahi udaas.
Haan. Lekin tumhari music mein bhi kaafi wo udaasi
ko
convert karke tum naach gaane mein bana.
Yeah, udaasi hi hoti hai lekin naachte hue, naachte hue udaasi.
Yeah.
You smile and be sad. Nahi nahi. I mean, we are people who feel strongly, I feel.
Yeah.
Emotional hai. हमारे अंदर बहुत ज़्यादा बट इट्स नॉट अ बैड थिंग
नो
कैन ऑल्सो बी अ बैड थिंग बट नॉट अ बैड थिंग
ऑल्सो लिरिक्स वाइज एंड सॉन्ग टॉपिक वाइज डू यू एवर फील लाइक यूर मे बी यू नीड टू कॉन्शियसली गो इन टू अ डिफरेंट जोन बिकॉज अक्सर लाइक क्रिएटिवली वी गेट इन टू अ कम्फर्ट जोन एंड वी राइट फ्रॉम अ सिमिलर प्लेस ऑन सिमिलर टॉपिक्स एंड वी आर ऑफन इग्नोरिंग अदर एस्पेक्ट्स बिकॉज एक में जोन बन रहा है. So do you feel like you need to force yourself out of that comfort zone sometimes?
Yeah, obviously. I also do it. I think I've done a house song
with
Khatra music. I don't think any of the popular artists right now are going towards that. I would love to. I'd love R&B as well, so I'm always going to hip-hop as well. And then I'm also doing this funk thing. I'm also doing a little bit of, what do you call it, Afrobeats. You know, so I do try a lot of different stuff out. In the sense, I always go with what I'm feeling.
Yeah.
You know, like even this year, I released a song. It's a Koi Nahi. It was about being lonely, you know, like never finding love.
Yeah.
I'm just going to be lonely. Never finding even companionship, you know, like friendship or anything. Just that I'm alone. So it's always about just what I'm feeling.
Yeah.
As I said, we are very emotional people.
Yeah.
I tend to, you know, like, infatuate a lot, I guess you could say. So I write about love. You know, I write about love. I think that's a language I know the best. I've been taught to love, you know.
Yeah.
Be kind. So I guess that's all I can write about these days now.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I feel like that will resonate more to the audience because it's becoming more truthfully from me.
Yeah, I mean, the main thing is to be honest to what you're feeling. And that has the best chance of resonating anyway. How is like being, you know, just do people recognize you out when you go in public and stuff? Like, does that start happening?
Sometimes. But itna nahi hota because everywhere I appear in shades. So I don't think people know what my eyes look like, but they saw a glimpse of it earlier because I forgot to put them back on after the break. But
is that why you do it consciously?
I also don't want people to see my eyes. I'm a little conscious of my eyes. You know, like when I'm performing, I don't want them to be able to see my eyes. That's a different element, but it also gives you confidence when you're on stage. But now it's just become part of the character, the Haji, I guess.
Yeah.
You know? So when I take my cap off or take this off, people don't recognize me.
That's useful.
Yeah.
It's like Slash without his top hair, hat or the hair covering his face.
I think his tattoos would give it away though.
Yeah. Well, you gotta hide that one then.
That's also true. I didn't think about that. No, tattoos do not give you away, guys.
Kya kehte hain? I think we have we've pretty much covered the whole gamut from your start to your current.
Yeah, kabhi hai na. Agli baar aur hoga. Agli baar 2 ghante ka hoga.
हाँ नहीं वो तो जितना एक्सपीरियंस बढ़ेगा उतना यू नो मटेरियल बढ़ेगा बट वी हैव अ कपल ऑफ ऑडियंस क्वेश्चंस दैट दे सबमिटेड सो आई एम जस्ट गोना ऑलराइट सो क्वेश्चन सेक्शन Harsher Bhatti asks, what keeps you driven and focused?
Just to know that I don't think I've achieved what I am meant to achieve yet. There's a lot more left to, you know, like, a lot more left to achieve. I'll say it again.
Yeah, abhi to shuruaat.
Yeah, abhi to shuruaat, you know, like, also just the fact, the support that I get, you know, the love I get from fans as well, from friends as well, from family as well now.
Yeah.
It's very important and it keeps me going. Also the fact that I'm lucky enough to be able to make my passion my job, my hobby, my job, you know.
That's a privilege.
That is a privilege. Not everyone has it. So
yeah,
knowing that I'm capable of doing that keeps me going, man.
Who taught you, this is Karan Kular, who taught you how to play bar chords?
It was a long process, I remember.
Yeah.
Because पहले मैं capo लगाता था guitar पे, जब भी कुछ कोई और scale बजाना होता था, नहीं होता था मेरे से bar chord. I used to try every time, नहीं होते थे. Like वो समझ आ गए थे, shape समझ आ गए थे.
Yeah.
सारे shape समझ आ गए थे, but वो switch नहीं किया जाता था, यहाँ से नहीं जाया जाता था. Then I remember I just left the guitar, like stopped playing it for 2 months.
Yeah.
And then one day I picked it up, and for some reason muscle memory kicked in and just started happening.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh. I could play bar chords, man. And that changed the game.
Yeah.
That really did change the game.
I mean, I remember when I was starting, obviously you start with some cheap-ass guitar that you've borrowed China from wala. Somewhere.
And
you don't have bar chords. It's not in tune.
Yeah. Guitar jo khareedte ho.
Then I happened to play someone's like nice, you know, expensive guitar. And I was like, it's so easy to play bar chords on this.
just happened with this.
So I think that's a lot to do with it as well.
Yeah, that could be actually, you know, because unka action itna high hota hai.
Exactly.
China wale jo guitar hote hain, like you're just like, kya ho raha hai,
bhai? Yeah, it's like, but then if you can do it on those, then you can do it anywhere.
Oh,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah.
Maybe that was the case, वैसे.
Yeah.
Yeah.
M H Wine asks, where did you learn the dance moves?
I don't know, man. I always had it in me. I think like, I remember. Even when I was a child, like when we had our Eid get togethers or anything,
yeah.
And family would put music on, everyone would dance, and I'd be there in the middle of the dancers going crazy, you know, like, yeah!
Yeah.
Yeah. At her wedding, Taha Ji hai. Taha Ji to nahi hota, Taha hai. Taha Guruwara. He's gonna come and perform.
Yeah.
For our side, you guys are losing.
Yeah, I mean, Mehndi, but you're the secret weapon.
Bhai, I am the weapon. I am the weapon. I should start charging for that too now.
Future career prospect.
Hey man, you can call my manager.
But yeah, no, that's all for now, and thank you for coming.
No, the pleasure was mine. I think it was long overdue.
Bilkul, yeah. And
especially
excited
at a place which has been part of my journey.
Absolutely.
For the longest time, yeah.
Absolutely. I think the first, I don't know, you've done probably 8-10 songs here, or something like that. But yeah, no, I'm super excited with your live band situation, and we definitely would want you guys to come and perform here as well.
Hopefully soon. As hopefully a live very, set. Very soon.
Yeah. And yeah, good luck with everything. And I'm sure you guys know Taha Ji. If you don't, check out his music. And if you have any further questions or whatever, just drop them in the comments. We'll ask them next time. And thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Peace.